Welcome. It's kind of my introduction piece, even though it's, let me get to a place where that's not going to happen.
Reed, can you tell them that popcorn and water are over
there? Oh, that's...
That Chris Fryer brought?
The most important is the popcorn and water are over there somewhere. On the table over there?
Yeah.
And... How lucky we are not to be in the Scottish Moors right now because it's very cold and wet and rainy there. But I'm going to take you there a lot today on a little tour. So I am Bryn Albanese. If you don't know how to say my last name, you have to use your hand. Albanese. Ready? Albanese. And then you'll never forget it. I am so happy to be here. I just, these concerts are so sustaining in every way to everyone. And we are so blessed to have this kind of weather and people who believe in the fact that we can do these concerts outside is just wonderful. So I'm gonna here to take you on a little journey. I have a one-woman show that I've been done 26 times outside since April 1st, and I'm having a wonderful time doing this, and I'll tell you more about it later, but I think I'm going to go right into some Bach. Now, Johann Sebastian Bach, of course, there's not enough repertoire for violin, right, Kathy? So, that's a joke, okay? But violinists still like to steal repertoire from other instruments because they just can't help it. So I've stolen the prelude of the cello suite, the number one cello suite, and I think that you will recognize it.
Okay, no feeding back. Thank you.
so many people say, I feel like buying a car after they hear that. Because it was used for the Honda Prelude commercial many, many years ago. Why do they use Bach to sell cars? I think it's because it's elegant and sophisticated. But I play Bach for different reasons. The cello, I just love that one so much. I have to get my little wind guard. I lost my little wind guard, so just a moment. So I have that wind guard so that you don't hear me breathing heavily into the microphone. I'm gonna move on to some Vivaldi. I'm going to play the entire season of autumn for you. And because it is autumn, and we are so lucky, because we have maybe 4 or 5 days of autumn here, or unlucky rather, and Vivaldi wrote some sonnets that I think are important to play, tell you about before I play. So in the first movement, you're going to see a scene set up, and the scene goes like this. The peasant celebrates in dance and song the sweet pleasure of the rich harvest, fired by Bacchus liquor. Many end their enjoyment in slumber. And then when I turn the page, I'll tell you about movement 2 and 3. So that's what you'll hear in the first movement. Thank you. Winter. So the farms are all closing up. There's a chill in the air and people are preparing for the long cold winter. That's in the second movement. He says, the air, which is fresher now, lends contentment, as the season which invited so many to great pleasure and also of sweetest slumber, makes each one abandon their dance and song and get to work. Oh, just tell you about the third movement. At the new dawn, the hunter set out on the hunt with horns and guns and the dogs. The wild beast flees and they follow its tracks. Already bewildered and wearied by the great noise, the beast is wounded. It threatens weakly to escape, but sadly overwhelmed and dies. I put the word sadly in there. Because, just as sad. The hunters return triumphantly and filled with gratefulness. They greet their families once again. That's the last movement.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Just delightful, delightful pieces that will never, I'll never get tired of playing. So thank you. I'm going to move in to a little bit of Scottish music now. Of course, as we go, I'll cross over more and more to some more modern types of music. Don't worry, there won't be any 12-tone, so.
Get rid of this.
So, many of you know me playing with Café Musique. Café Musique was supposed to say farewell a bunch of different times. We had a lot of concerts scheduled in May, April and May. Of course, they've been canceled, and I don't think that we're going to be getting back together again to say a proper farewell, because everyone's moving on to different projects in life. But I still am playing with a couple of the Café Musique members, Eric Williams and Fred Murray, and we have a little group called Classa Nova. And it's basically classical violin meets the bossa nova, and many jazz standards, and just a lot of fun material that we've been doing together. Right now, we're sort of at a little bit at a standstill, but we did kick off the first online series concert on the PAX stage back in March. No, it was just last month. See, I don't even know. It's like March would just happened. and it was just a lot of fun. We had a wonderful time. So today, I'm going to play Calliope House and Cowboy Jig, and I've got Fred and Eric who have graciously recorded the background for me so I could bring it to my audiences for the one-woman show. So here we go.
Thank you.
delightful, delightful music that I've been going to the Valley of the Moon Scottish Fiddling School for the last few years, and I'm so sad to have had to miss that this year, but hopefully but next summer I'll be able to go back, because it's just, I learned so much there. This music is really good for the technique, it's good for teaching. The kids, even my older adult students, they just love it, and it's pretty easy to learn. So, not the way I play it, I mean, with all the accessories, but the tunes are nice and easy. So, those of you who know Cafe Musique know that we've been on Uniworld riverboat cruises, and we did 5 of them, and brought all of our fans with us, and we've been to France a few times. And while in France, I thought, I think Cafe Musique needs a French medley. So this is my arrangement of 3 Edith Piaf tunes, C'est si bon, c'est magnifique, and Milo. And Classanova has finally recorded it. So we're in the process of making an album. It's very slow going right now. But I hope you enjoy it. So C'est si bon, c'est magnifique, and Milo. A 1, 2, 3, 4. Thank you. that Edith Piaf was responsible for winning World War II. The French think that. Because she would go down into the trenches and sing for the soldiers. And risked her life to do that. She was a pretty amazing little lady. I think she was like 4'11 or something like that. She's super tiny. So I just said, I love Edith Piaf. Let me see what's up next. So I played for many years with the Boston Pops and some years with the symphony. Boston Pops was one of my favorite groups to ever play in, and learned so much about swing music and big band. I mean, New Year's Eve, they'd take out all the seats in Symphony Hall in Boston, and then they had this dance, and everyone was, I mean, it was like taking you back to the 40s every single year. It was pretty amazing. So playing under John Williams was wonderful, but there's one composer I didn't really spend very much time with, and that was Ennio Morricone, who we lost this year. He was in his 80s. And Mr. Morricone wrote the most beautiful theme for the movie Cinema Paradiso. And so I'm going to play the violin, the love theme from Cinema Paradiso. And I hope you enjoy it. How are you all doing? Fine? Good? Okay.
Thank you.
think that's one of my new favorites. During the lockdown, it was amazing to just sit in front of the computer and try to work out all of this technology. And in the concerts, the beginning when I was online, I did a little fundraiser, and I was able to raise money to go back to school. So I am now in school again. I'm 52, and I decided, since things are so weird as it is, and we're not really gonna go back to any kind of orchestra stuff, or that maybe I can just pursue the program I want. So I am in a program called Musicians for Healing and Transitions. And I've always wanted to be a music therapist, but it was too many hours, too expensive, and I wanted to be able to be a performer while going to school. And it was almost impossible to do that way back when I wanted to go into the program. And then a hospice musician is sort of doesn't do exactly what I wanted to do for the music therapy. So there's something in between, and I couldn't believe it, an actual nationally recognized accredited program. And in all the hospitals from San Jose up north, they actually employ what are called CMPs, Certified Music Practitioners. And they go around in all the hallways and to each room. And we are being trained. I am being trained to look at someone's chart to see what they're ailing, what is their ailment, if they are freshly out of a surgery, or if they've had a stroke, if they've had heart issues, high blood pressure, and all different pain management type music that I'm learning about, cognitively impaired, and of course the actively dying. So I'm learning all of that, and it's 5 modules, and it's the most incredible program. And my goal is to, when I get my certificate, to go to our local care centers and hospitals and try to implement musical programming, which has never been done before. Yes, it's something extremely important. So why am I telling you all this? Well, many of you know that I've been concertmaster of this and that and in town, and I have now retired or resigned from all of the groups as concertmaster, including the last group that I played with recently with San Luis Obispo Symphony, but I have now resigned from San Luis Obispo Symphony because I want to put all of my eggs in this basket. And then I am doing these musical outreaches, which I'll tell you about, to the schools in a little while. So I think no program of mine is right without a Mexican polka, so here we go. This is Cafe Musique and Louis Ortega, and it's so fun to play with our own CDs. So this is Cafe Musique. Yeah. So, so fun. So, I have so many things to tell you, but I won't talk so much. So let me just take a drink and we'll go on to... I forgot I was gonna do this today. So I'm gonna sing you a song that I wrote. And I wrote the words, and it's all about San Luis Obispo County. So a few years ago, or about a year ago when I finished this song, I wrote to the County Office of Tourism. And I said, hey guys, I have a song. I think it would help people if they moved in the area. You know, it kind of tells about different areas of town and little tidbits about it, and I think it might help, so I hope you like it. So I sent it off to them, and I'm gonna sing it for you, and then I'll tell you what happened. Little help from Eric Williams. It's called Here and Slow. You kind of like it here and slow, where all the happy people go. And if you wanna be a dolly, you'll have to study at Cal Poly. Then maybe go and drink some wine. Soon you'll be feeling super fine. You kind of like it here in slow. Then you could drive out to the Bear, Los Osos, where no one cares about their hair. Because there's always so much fog, and everybody has a dog, and all the septic tanks were clogged until they vented felt the sewer. And now it all has been flushed away. You could try out Morro Bay, where people go and play all day. You can eat some fish and chips and do some shopping that is kitsch. Take a stroll down to the Shell Shop. Enjoy a cocktail at the Otter Rock. You'd rather like it there in Morro Bay. If you're from Atascadero, you know it's hot like habanero. But all the housing is so cheap, that makes it easier to sleep. Many small businesses could start, because they didn't build a Walmart. You'd really like it there, Atascadero. Further north's a place called Paso, where you can learn to use a lasso. And folks are out to make some bucks, so they can buy their two-ton trucks. That's why there's never any parking when you go shopping at the Food Barn. Maybe love it there in Paso Robles. Further west is Cambria. Some people call it Cambria. There are galleries of art and many people who are smart. The average age is over 55. So if you're young and want to socialize, you better head on out. You better move back down to slow. Right? True. I don't know if the Los Osos part, the hair thing is true, but because you all look pretty nice. But I mean, sometimes you can't do anything about it, right? It's just so foggy. Although you probably get, you're right on the edge of the fog here, oftentimes, yeah. Okay, so what happened? So they wrote me back, and they said, thank you very much for your submission. I'm afraid there is content that we are not able to use in this song. And that was it. Darn it. I think it would be awfully helpful. I don't know about you, but I think Paso Robles sounds pretty awesome, except for the parking part. So I haven't done any, tango, so I'm going to do one now. It's by Piazzolla, and it's a very slow, gorgeous, sensual tango called Oblivion. And I found all of these backing tracks that you're hearing. Some of them are Cafe Musique, some of them Classanova, but many of them are just ones that I found during the pandemic. And my pianist, his name is Paul, in the beginning, and he's from the UK. And he has a site that has like 100 violin pieces that he has recorded on the piano, and you just download them and that's it. But you have to follow his musicality, which is, you know, he does his best. And so it's been amazing. So here we go, Oblivion. Thank you. is kind of a new one for me. And I'm going to keep playing that. I'm probably going to record it. Right now I'm also recording a Celtic album with my dentist friend up in Cambria, Jill Poulis, the Celtic harp player. So that's coming out. So we're still finding ways, finding ways to make music. And I wanted to let you know something really cool about this one-woman show. I just got hired by the County Office of Education to do a series, an online series for the SLO County Schools of 7 episodes. That's kind of a dumbed down version of the PBS, the Festival Mosaics, Now Hear This. So it's gonna be exploring the world through music with Bryn Albanese. So yeah, I'm so excited. So that and the Music for Healing and Transitions program is gonna keep me pretty busy. And this is how I'm making a living now, just going out and taking advantage of the beautiful weather. And I'm also doing Zoom holiday concerts, which are really gonna be fun. I'm playing a drive-in concert at the Jewish Temple Ner Shalom, which I'm really excited about on the 29th. And just getting called for kind of all interesting different projects that I never ever would have pursued if it hadn't been for the pandemic. So in a way for me, it bittersweet. I mean, I don't like the way things are going. No one does, but I'm just so happy to be here and be able to make music and play for you and make you happy. So yes, so on to the next. Oh, we have to go back to France now, of course. So this is one of my favorite pieces of Café Musique. It's called Indifference. And we found it on it when we were on the metro, riding the subway in Paris. Everyone was packed on like sardines. I mean, you can't do that anymore, I guess, you know, without your mask. But this accordion player like smashed himself on at the very last minute and played this piece. And I was mesmerized, so mesmerized that I actually followed him. He probably thought I was some weird lady. I mean, can you imagine? Like, when you're an American tourist and you're a female, you're supposed to be followed. But now I was following him, and he kept looking back like I was some weirdo. But I was. I wanted to know what that piece was, so he told me. Anyway, Indifference. Thank you. I'll always have such fantastic memories of those Uniworld trips. I do run a concert series in Cambria. It's called Cambria Concerts Unplugged, and I don't allow big sound systems. So I try to hire bands from all over, hire groups, and I had a wonderful season planned for this year that's already happened, but hopefully maybe we'll have the same people come next year. And Inga Swearingen, it's just an amazing little chapel in Cambria. It's the Chapel on the Hill, if you've ever been to it. It's an incredible place. It has extraordinary acoustics. And when I was preparing for a Bach concert in the Mission, I was practicing in there, and it was truly an amazing place. So I have a table over there that has all kinds of fun little information. And if you, thank you so much for your donations. If you want to put just a little bit more cash, please take CDs with you. You can look at them. I have a hospice CD there that I has Schindler's List. It has so many different numbers on it that I donated to hospice. I donated 200 copies to Wilshire and then also to the Slow Hospice. And I have an email sign-up sheet, and I have some cards and even some stickers for Cafe Musique, so please enjoy yourself over there. And I'm going to play another Scottish medley that is out of this world. And it's by a band called the Arm Breakers. It's true. It's true. And I don't have it quite memorized, so give me a moment to set it up. It's from a Scottish barn dance. So like you would hear people playing this together, probably 10 violinists all together, and people dancing, probably about 150 to 250 people dancing to this in a barn. So hold on for a second. This is kind of a new one for me. And soon I'll have it by memory. Alistair Fraser would be so angry with me that I'm using music. He's like, you should play everything by ear. Yeah, well, you know. I'm trained to read music, so I might as well use it to my advantage. Alrighty, so I'm gonna shake it all out. The first one's called Sporting Paddy, and then Hamish the Carpenter, Into Hull's Reel, and then The Road to Aerogy. So enjoy this. Thank you. Ouch. That's all I can say. I know, it's like, you know, there's a, I played at Valley of the Moon, we did this set, and I was like, I have to get the music for that. Shh, don't tell anybody. And there's like these, you know, little kids playing this. There were like 25 violinists playing that together. It was just the most incredible sound. The Arm Breakers, what a wonderful name for a group. All right, we're coming down to the end. I can't believe this. Carmen, thank you so much for organizing this, and thank you to the park, Daisy Hills, for closing off the street, and for all of you to come out and support live music and what we can have, what's left of it right now. But we'll get out of this. We'll get out, and then we'll all be back together again inside, hopefully. So let me see. What am I going to play now? Ah, one of Cafe Musique's favorite tunes to play and watch people dance to is the Lover's Waltz. And I love playing to this as well. So we're going to do Lover's Waltz. And then my finale, which I won't tell you because you probably already know it.
Thank you.
That is called The Lover's Waltz. That's on our latest CD, which I have over there, called Ebb and Flow. All right, I'm at the end. I can't believe it. This is perfect timing. Let me tune again because I care. I'll tune with this off though. If you're wondering what type of violin I have, it's a carbon fiber violin. I have a wooden one, but it's too nice to bring out. Try to protect it as much as possible. It's in quarantine right now. And it's a Swarovski crystals all over this violin. I painstakingly put each one of them on. During the lockdown, there was nothing else to do. Started bejeweling my mom and dad. They're in their 80s. They're both getting eye surgeries on Tuesday at the same time. So my dad's getting his left eye and my mom's getting a right eye. And I bought pirate hats. And they don't know this yet, but when we get out of the surgery, they're both going to have patches. And I'm going to put their pirate's hats on and take pictures of them. That's what you do with parents at that age, because they just don't ever say no anymore. They used to say no all the time. They don't say no anymore. It's great. Love it. Okay. All right, so I've been playing this since I was 7 years old. I think I know it now, and it's just so fun to play with the recording. It's Chardosh! Kathy, you knew I was going to play that, right? It's not often that someone in the audience is more famous than me. But today, we do have Miss Kathy Linsky, who is amazing! She's the whole reason why Kathy has helped me so much through the years, so I'm just so happy to be playing for you too, Kathy. So, Chardosh! Thank you. Appreciate it. Yeah.